So hello guys, this is Arslan and you're watching AI YouTube channel, which is Arslan Ikram YouTube channel. As I said before that I'm going to bring a laser tutorial from the movie Eternals. So let's get straight into the video. First, go to the footage and drag and drop into the new comp. The next step is to find the exact time where you're going to shoot the laser. In my case, I'm going to start from here. So right click on the mouse, go to new and select the null object. Next, rename it to the left eye or whatever you call it, then duplicate it and rename it to the right eye. Next, go to the main project and right click, then select track stabilization and go to track motion. Zoom it and expand the box area. Before doing any further, go to the main comp and set the quality to high so your tracker won't lose the area. Put the tracker on the eye and for the bonus tip, select the contrast area so you won't lose the tracking. Now simply go to the tracking panel and just start tracking by just pressing this forward button. As you can see, our tracking is working pretty well, huh? So finally it's done and you will lose some parts, but it is okay, we will fix it manually. Now go to the edit target and select the null. In my case I am tracking left eye, so I will select the left track object and then simply apply and hit OK. So as you can see, our tracking is working pretty well. Well, let's check. Yeah, it's working. And as you can see, it's sticking on my eye. Yeah, you will lose some parts, but we have to fix it manually, as I said. So just simply expand this area and go to the first keyframe. And just by pressing page up, you will go to back. You can go to back and press this box by manually. So it will automatically create the keyframe as you want. Now simply do the same with the second side. And delete the other keys. Now trim it from the both side, and once you are done with the both eye, you will get this amazing tracking data. And now for the veins effect, you need this water reflection image. I'll put the link in the description so you'll get the same image I am working on. Now go to the main comp and mask out some areas where you want to put the veins. In my case, I need this area to highlight. Drag and drop the water reflection image and expand it or scale it according to your need. Now put the tint above the curves and simply highlight and contrast some areas by just simply adjusting the curves and set it to screen. Now simply adjust again to hide the alpha. And yeah, it's pretty good. Now create a new solid by clicking the right button on the mouse and rename it to Alpha Matte or Matte. This is just a guide layer for us. So pick up the pen tool and mask out the area. Unhide the image and set it to Alpha Matte. Then select both the layer and pair it to the left eye tracking object. Now simply unhide the mask, hide the mask and press F and feather it out. It will make the edge soften, so it will look cool. Now simply select both the layers and duplicate. Now simply select the above image and scale it out to create more depth. Now go to effects panel, search fractal noise and drag and drop it on the first image layer. Now tweak some settings and set it to dynamic and scale it according to your need and set the screen to multiply, and you will get this more depth effect. Now tweak some settings according to your need. Now go to the evolution, hold the alt key and press the left mouse button. Now type this expression so that it will give some motionary depth inside the veins. Now you can simply duplicate the fractal noise. Now select all the effects, go to edit, copy and paste it on the above layer. Now simply select above the veins effect and pre-compose. I'll call it veins or whatever you call it, it's totally up to you. Now you can see it's not sticking on my eyes, so we can adjust it and pair it to the left tracking object. Now go to inside the veins and we will create some more veins with the help of pen tool, and you can adjust the stroke number according to your need. Then set it to overlay so it will blend perfectly. Now copy the effects from the second layers and paste it on the above layer so it will create more depth. Now simply go to effect panel and search the fast blur or fast box blur, whatever you have, whatever the version you have, you can simply put it on the above layer. Now simply copy the fast box blur and paste it on the second and third image layer. Now simply duplicate the alpha matte and put it above. Now simply set it to alpha matte so it will blend perfectly. Now adjust the mask according to your need, and if it goes out of your face you can simply adjust the mask, and for me this is good. So simply go to the effects panel, search curves and drag and drop on the above veins layer and readjust. Now create a new solid and rename it to left eye. Now simply zoom in, pick up the pen tool and mask out the eye area and the outside area as well. Now unhide the mask, press M and set it to intersect. Now simply press F on keyboard and feather it out to make it blend perfectly. Now the next step is to animate the mask path by simply click on the stopwatch and animate it, and you will get this effect. Now go to the effects panel and search fractal noise, drag and drop on the above layer and do the same as we did before. Adjust the brightness and contrast to make it blend perfectly, and next step is to animate the evolution by simply hold the alt key and click the left key on the mouse and type the expressions as we did before, so you will get this cool motion effect. Apply the curves effect. Now simply adjust the red channel and blue channel to get this orangey effect, and you can also duplicate it, but let's set it to add, and again go to the effects panel and search glow. Now tweak some settings on the glow and duplicate it so you will get this orangey glow effect. Looks nice. Now duplicate the layer and put it on the second eye and adjust the mask according to your need, as I said before, and pair it to the right eye object, and you will get this cool amazing effect. Now animate it with the right hand side so you'll get this closing effect. It looks nice, na? Yeah, I know, I'm great. Okay, so let's create another solid, and this time we will rename it laser left, or simply go to the effects panel and type saber. and set it to fire and tweak some settings. First, we will blend it, simply just add it and set the start point and end point. You can see it's already looking pretty nice. You need to unhide some effect if your computer is getting slow. Now first, pair it to the left eye data. Now play with the start size and end size, as well as with the glow effect, glow spread effect, glow bias effect. Then go to distortion effect, play with distortion amount, scale size, wind speed, and you can change the color if you want more heated effect, and you will get this nice lasery effect. Now go to the distortion again, core distortion, and tweak these settings. You can also copy my settings, so you'll get this exact laser effect. Now let's solo all the layers and it will look like this. See, it's amazing, you know. And now when you set the video quality to high, you will see these veins effect. It will look nice. You can also adjust the scale if it goes out of the frame by simply click S on the keyboard and rescale it. After that, you can adjust it again. And now duplicate it, put it above on all the layers. Now simply we are going to create some sparks. Now set the preset layer to tractor beam and then tweak some settings like glow, starting point, end point. But the main part is core distortion and glow distortion. You have to set it properly to create more depth and to create more static electricity. And you can also copy all my settings if you want. You can also slow down my video. Once you are done, you need to change the color to orangey color or spark color, which is red. Now apply the CC vector blur, then directional blur, to create more static spark line. Now play with these settings to create more depth and it will look great. But it looks a bit slow, so tweak some settings again. You can play with wind speed and noise speed, also with noise scale if you want. So it will look like this. You can copy my settings as well. And with all these settings we have done, it will look like this. See, it's amazing now. And this is how it looks. I know it looks amazing. I'll solo the layer so you can see more properly. See, a laser with the sparky lines looks amazing. We are almost done. Just create a new adjustment layer, then rename it to heat or heat distortion, then apply the heat distortion effect and mask out some areas. Then tweak some settings, play with wind direction. You can set it to 90 degree or 80 degree if you want. Play with these settings to create a distortion and wavy effect, because our laser is producing heat, so we need to distort it. Then pair it to the null object, right or left, whatever you want. Then feather it out, mask out some areas, and if you want, you can animate the opacity, and you can again play with heat, as I said. And with all the settings and the adjustment and color correction done, also I have applied some glow effect on the face, so it will look like this with all the compilation. And I have also applied the lens effect, so it will look cool. Now simply go to the opacity, hold alt and write these expressions. So it will look like this, a flashy effect, right? Now select all the layers, pre-compose and call it shake effect. or shake. Now simply scale a bit and then we have to apply some shake effect. Now split the layer, then apply the wiggle effect by simply clicking the Alt key on the keyboard and left key on the mouse. Apply wiggle effect, adjust some settings, don't do the mistake I have done, and yeah, it will look cool once it is done. See? So thank you so much for watching. You don't know how hard these presentations are, and maybe if I have done something wrong, please don't blame me, and you can also comment me and tell me that what part you have liked the most and what not. So guys, thank you so much. Don't forget to like this video, share this video, and do tell me in the comment. Okay, don't forget.